Hey everybody, what's going on? Leo here from Daddy's Game Time, your friendly show about gaming, movies, and pop culture. And today we're melancholic, I guess you could say. Last night was the Nintendo Switch stream, and a lot of people are disappointed by what they saw out of Nintendo, including yours truly here. I'm going to try and be fair. I'm gonna try and give Nintendo the benefit of the doubt. However, what I saw out of Nintendo was a complete disregard for what the gamers have been calling for the last few years out of Nintendo. Actually, ever since they fumbled the ball with the Wii U, Nintendo has been unable to just kind of get a grasp of what gamers are really about in this modern time. They seem to be kind of stuck with trying to chase that ghost of the Nintendo Switch, and it's probably going to prove to be a mistake. I'm going to give you my honest review of what I think the Nintendo Switch is going to be doing for the gaming industry in the next couple of years. And so far, from if this is the tone they're trying to set, it doesn't look very promising. Game consoles are always supposed to be about games, and the Nintendo Switch seems to be all about their hardware right now. And quite frankly, even though the first party titles do seem impressive, the support that it's getting seems to be very out of date. I'm talking about games like Skyrim. It's a great game. It's a wonderful game. However, it's an outdated game. Skyrim is a game that has been out for the PlayStation 3. I think it's a more than 5-year-old game at this point, and they're still going to just barely release it on a Nintendo console. This should have been something that was released for a Nintendo console last gaming generation with the Wii U. The Wii U should have been on par with the PlayStation 4 or Xbox One. However, Nintendo has been just trying to play the game of we're not about power, we're not about this, we're not about that. Well, you know what, Nintendo? Last time that I saw you being number one in the industry, you were about all those things. Back with the Nintendo and the Super Nintendo, they were the strongest consoles available at the time. And it showed with the wonderful, wonderful games such as Donkey Kong, and the games such as Star Fox Zero, where you were able to actually produce something because of the console's power. You were able to produce something that was not easily produced or produced at all in any of your competitors' consoles. That's what kind of put you over the edge. That's what set you up as a trendsetter. That's what set you up as an innovator to begin with in the gaming industry. Yes, we know it's not about power. Yes, we know it's not about the prettiest graphics. But without that power, you won't be able to innovate in some of the ways that are needed to innovate. And yes, Nintendo is just kind of chasing that ghost again of the Nintendo Wii, and it's a big mistake. I think that Nintendo needs to bring it with the games. I mean, we already know the Nintendo Switch is the Nintendo Switch's graphics are set in stone for the time being until they release like a Switch version 1.5 or something like that, where they are able to get a better battery performance out of it, slightly better graphics out of it. That's fine, but for the time being, I don't see the games, I don't see the support out of third parties. What they have going for them is a port of a Wii U game in Zelda Breath of the Wild, and the only original new IP title that seems to be very exciting. Actually, it's not even a new IP, it's just a new title. It's Super Mario Odyssey. That's the only thing that got me really excited besides what was already announced in Zelda Breath of the Wild. And it's a shame, really. I should be looking forward to more than just these two games for Nintendo's brand new console. I should be more excited than what I am, because everything else just seems like some sort of version of Wii Sports, something that's just trying to take advantage of the Nintendo's mobility. Is that your innovation, mobility? Come on, Nintendo. Tablets have been out for a few years now. Mobile phones have been out for a few years now. You're gonna have to bring it with something better than just that. Even with that said, though, I know I sound like I'm hating on Nintendo. I, for many years, have considered myself a Nintendo fanboy, and I still do in many respects. And I see Nintendo as almost that family member that's kind of like not going the right direction in life, and you try to give him advice because you love him, not because you hate him. And that's what I see Nintendo doing right now. I really don't see them being successful, at least not for the long term, when they continue to make decisions like the Nintendo Switch. They need to be, more than anything, about the games. They need to be able to cater to the hardcore audience, which is with games, not even with the type of innovations that they claim to be having, which in reality, slap on a set of controls to any tablet that already exists and you already have a Nintendo Switch. By this time next year, you're going to have something much more powerful than a Nintendo Switch already. And that's not something to be too impressed about. The main draw that Nintendo has always had are their first party titles. I'm talking about The Legend of Zelda. I'm talking about Super Mario. I'm talking about Donkey Kong. I'm talking about Metroid. I'm talking about Star Fox. I'm talking about F-Zero. I'm talking about all those titles that are wonderful, wonderful titles that only Nintendo can bring. And they've had a long time without releasing anything for the Nintendo Wii U. They should have more in the back burner to showcase for the Nintendo Switch. However, they don't, and that is a mystery. Nintendo seems to be having bad bad way of showing customers why they should be excited, showing fans why they should be excited for this console. So far, it's just been a letdown. I was excited for the console, but now that they actually had their reveal, I'm not so excited. And it also shows on the bottom line of Nintendo. Their stock went down about 10 points yesterday, which is not something to be too excited about if you're a Nintendo supporter. Because Nintendo, we all want Nintendo to be successful because we know what they're capable of. However, in recent times, they have just been very out of touch, very out of place with their fan base and with the gaming community in general. So if you're watching me out there, I just want to know, like, what are your thoughts about it? Make sure you leave comments down below. And I'm very, very excited still for the gaming industry itself. I think that if Nintendo fails with the Switch, we're going to end up seeing a lot of Nintendo games on either Sony's or Microsoft's console. And that's kind of a shame, really. I mean, it would probably be a good thing for gamers to see Nintendo's games on other consoles. However, it's not something that we're used to seeing, and it quite frankly would be kind of odd to see, kind of like when we saw Sega first start making games for Nintendo, for Xbox, for all the other competitors. It's just not the same, and I think that the industry will not be the same without Nintendo bringing it in terms of hardware like they always do, because they always do look to innovate. They don't look just for these marginal graphics increases. They don't. They look for different ways to play the game. I give them credit for that. However, they also need to stay on par with what some of their competitors are doing, in addition to the innovation. That's where the Nintendo magic comes from. And I don't know. I'm just very disappointed, not only with their marketing, but also with the lack of games to be excited about. I think that they have extreme stiff competition for the launch window of the Nintendo Wii U. The Nintendo Switch. And I think a lot of people that don't have that title, like Breath of the Wild, because they don't have a Wii U, because they don't have a Nintendo Switch, I don't even think they're really going to miss not playing it. Why? Because the people are going to have titles such as Horizon Zero Dawn to keep them busy. And that looks to be a massive title coming out from Sony. And who knows? Who knows what's going to happen to Nintendo if this turns out to be a complete failure. I think that, yes, you're going to hear a lot of buzz in the first weeks out of Nintendo, because Nintendo always does that. They always sell out. All the hardcore Nintendo fans always sell out their consoles, at least in the beginning they do. And after some time, like when it's time to sell the console to the more casual fans, that's when Nintendo's probably going to be suffering a little bit. And that's really a shame. Nobody wants to see Nintendo suffer whatsoever. I think that we're starting to get to that point where if this system is a failure for Nintendo, they might start looking for other options. Now, I said I was going to bring you also my review for the Nintendo Switch. And there's a few categories, a few different things that we're looking at when it comes to this console here. And Rick on daddysgametime.com gave his review of the Switch. The different factors are first impression, launch games, graphics, peripherals, and price point. I think first impression was from the reveal trailer that we got back in October. That first impression was wonderful. I would say I would give it an 8 out of 10 on first impression, because that showcased a lot of what the hardware was about. Then launch games, after what we saw yesterday, Breath of the Wild, that's the only launch game that is impressive at all. But considering I already have a Wii U, I'm not really looking forward to playing it on the Nintendo Switch. I'm going to get Breath of the Wild for the Wii U, and I'm going to play it there, because that's my console of choice to play Breath of the Wild on. And I'm not too excited about any of the other launch lineup games. 1-2 Switch, that seems like the type of game that you probably pick up one time with a couple of buddies at a party that you set up at home, or a barbecue, and that's it. I see myself only as playing that game one time, as well as the other games I saw for the launch window. ARMS, that just seemed like a one-time play for me. Nothing too excited whatsoever. So in terms of launch games, I would give it a one out of 10, which is terrible, a failure. One just for Breath of the Wild, and I'm sure that's going to be a wonderful game, but it's not exactly a console exclusive. It's also going to be available on the Wii U. Now, graphics. Here's a big gripe I've had with the console. It's outdated. However, I'm going to rate it as a modular device. And as far as graphics go, definitely if I was basing my graphics impressions from a console, I would give it a 2 out of 10. However, I'm going to be a little generous here and grade this as strictly a modular device. And so in terms of graphics, I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10 because it does a lot of things that a lot of other mobile devices don't do. So you have that. Peripherals, the Joy-Con and the PlayStation, the Joy-Con and the Pro Controller for Nintendo, I would give the peripherals a high grade, 7 out of 10. However, I'm not. And the reason is because they're grossly overpriced. They really are ripping people off with these very high prices. The Pro Controller for the Nintendo Switch is going to be $70 plus tax. Their Joy-Con set is going to be $80 plus tax. If you're going to look to buy an individual Joy-Con controller, that's going to set you back $50 plus tax each. And that's just the beginning of it. There's many more peripherals as well that are grossly overpriced. And I, quite honestly, I just shake my head. I'm shaking my head. I don't know what Nintendo is doing. And it's just a shame. It's a shame. I don't understand what Nintendo is thinking with these extremely high prices for these peripherals. I don't know what Nintendo is thinking with the high price of the price point. That's the next thing I'm getting to. The price point of the console itself, $299.99 US. It's too high. It's too high. I thought initially they were releasing the price and they were going to say it comes bundled with a new game. But no, it doesn't come bundled with a game. It's just the console only with the controller that every console should just come with a controller. And so that's just a big head turner. I wonder why they're charging so much for something that doesn't even have cutting edge visuals compared to the competition. And I know it's going to seem like I'm contradicting myself because I gave the graphics department such a high score, but you got to really understand the true competitors, regardless of what Nintendo tells you, the true competition is Microsoft and Sony, and they're just not bringing it whatsoever. They're not even there. They're not even in the same league as Sony and Microsoft right now, and I think that they're going to enjoy their couple months of sold out consoles, and then reality is going to start setting in, just like it did with the Nintendo Wii U, where hey, nobody's buying the console. I wonder why. And it's because of the games. Bottom line is always games. The gamers want games, and the manufacturers sometimes get too caught up in all these other corporate shenanigans, and they're trying to sell you a vision that they want out of you. However, it's a vision that's not necessarily what the gamers want, and Nintendo is failing miserably when it comes to that. So, first impressions, launch games, graphics, peripherals, price point. The price point, I give it a 2 out of 10 as well. So it's just all bad. It's almost all bad across the board. I don't like what Nintendo's doing. I'm going to give them a chance, though. I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt. However, they got to bring me the games. They got to show me with the games that they got what it takes. Whereas right now, I'm sorry, but there's only two games I'm interested in. Zelda and the new Mario. And they look wonderful. They look like system seller type of games. However, I'm tired of having to pay $300+ for a console only to play the Nintendo first party titles. You know what? Give me something new. Give me something that's going to make me feel like Nintendo cares again. Feel excited for some of these franchises that are old and some of the franchises that are new. I know Nintendo has the talent to do it, but whether they want to do it, that's the big question. So with that said, thank you very much for joining me today here on Daddy's Game Time. And until next time, remember, check us out on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and also on Instagram. Enjoy your games and love your families.